to the Punny Game Show Quiz, a game show consisting of three rounds full of jokes, laughter, and wordplay. The first round will be called Word on the Street. The second will be called Overly Pretentious. And the third should be called Songbirds. Let's meet our contestants. On my right, we have Jago and Daniel, known collectively as Team JD. And on my left, we have Dowie and James, known collectively as Team DJ. Let's get into the game, ladies and gentlemen. So, our first round, as we mentioned earlier, will be called Word on the Street. In order to get points here, you must successfully give a definition of a word I give you from Urban Dictionary. Points will also be awarded for funny or amusing answers, as determined by me. Apologies, ladies and gentlemen. So let's get to it. Our first words. Dude bro. Can anyone give us a definition for dude bro?
An extremely close male friend.
An extremely close brother. I mean,
it's close, but
a dude bro.
It's not kind of what I've got here, so I can't award points. So,
do you like hang out with your brother?
Yeah.
No, unfortunately not. It's a lot simpler as a definition.
It's a lot simpler?
Yeah. It's a much simpler definition. Dude bro.
A friend.
Friend? Could be, but not necessarily.
Could be.
Any other answers, or should we cut it there?
A marijuana buddy.
A marijuana buddy is not the correct answer.
Oh, okay.
Is it a crack cocaine buddy?
It's not anyone who consumes crack cocaine, as far as I'm aware.
Your number one male friend.
I mean, it's not usually exclusive. No, right, we're going to cut it there. The definition I have written down here for dude bro is someone who is likely to both use dude and bro in the same sentence.
What? Simpler.
Oh yes.
Yeah,
right. I haven't heard that kind of thing either. So, our next thing we want to define is a word that I don't know I'll be able to pronounce, to be fair. It is Ludwig van Quixote. That is Ludwig van Quixote. Can anyone give me a definition for that?
I'm guessing it's foreign.
Ludwig.
It doesn't seem to be foreign from what I've seen.
Oh, okay.
What?
Someone who thinks they're great and making music.
Is it?
Ooh, someone who thinks they're great, maybe getting there. Maybe getting there with that. Half a point for Jago here. Team JG.
Why? Literally every time you give Jago points.
Oh, maybe you should get some yourself then. Come on, give us definition.
What? You got half a point
for someone who thinks he's quite great. What can we add to that?
You've got half a point for
Jago.
Someone who thinks on the level of Ludwig.
No, that's just going a bit far. You're pushing it now.
All right, well, you're giving up points for the last answer, so I'll figure.
Someone that thinks he's better than everyone else.
Yeah, I could give you half a point maybe for that as well.
Yeah. What's that last word? Ludwig.
Yeah, can you pronounce that?
Ludwig van Quixote.
Quixote.
One word as it's written here. Any answers or no?
No.
I'm going to pass.
Okay, so the definition we have here is a fanatic obsessed with pseudoscience and propaganda, an alarmist,
what?
Or a fool with delusions of grandeur. What? So really someone who's a fake or a poser but thinks they're quite great, bigs himself up.
Jago,
potentially. Points for that.
Oh,
like that.
Oh, good.
Nice. Show you got the sander. Okay, so our third word for today. Our third word is the word phrase driving the Bronco. Oh. What are we feeling about driving the Bronco then, ladies and gentlemen?
Running out of the bush.
No,
give him points.
It is not half a point for running out of the bush, bonus point there. It's not running out of the bush. Any other
sex
ideas?
Sex position.
It's not a sex position.
Sure, no, I get points for that though.
Do we say he gets points for that, guys?
Yeah, give it to
him. Oh, it's
given
it.
It's given it.
Top line. Yeah, one thanks.
Driving the Bronco, ladies and gentlemen.
Could it be being an accomplice to a crime?
Oh, accomplice to a crime.
That.
Got it exactly.
I completely forgot to.
Driving the Bronco, an accomplice to a crime. What do you mean forgot? You never knew it. okay. So. And another definition we have for today. What is your definition of the word hundo?
Married man.
St- It's not a married man, no. It's not a married man. Any other answers?
Is this the one we never found? I can't remember.
What do you mean never found? I've never been here before.
Oh, right, okay.
100.
100? Is something still 100? 100 people. 100 people? Not 100 people. 100
people. Is it like an item?
100 boys. 100 girls.
Not 100 boys.
Does it have cumulative
100
boys?
Sexual partners.
No, not really. Nothing to do with sexual partners either.
Like 100 spots.
It's not 100 spots. Hundo, defined here, is 100%. So there we go.
Right.
100%.
Yeah.
I think Jamie was getting at that.
He was getting at it, but wasn't quite there, so I don't know if I can allow it.
Alright.
Okay.
And our last word for today is the word one-gina.
Married man.
Oh my god,
one-gina. Really? Is that right?
You got there immediate.
Oh, yes.
I don't know why you have such knowledge for one giant. Why do you know the word one giant? Do you
want to
tell us the story?
He's a married man.
Well, basically, yep. Went on to
Urban Dictionary and have a look.
Right.
He's done his research.
Oh, come on. He's done made a good story.
He's done his research. He's really not helping me.
And I'm a married man.
Well, you're married. I'd like to say complete quick congratulations. Round of applause from the studio audience, please. Okay. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is all we have for the definitions round.
What's the scores?
The scores currently stand at.
I think we win.
Yeah.
I
got a 1-1.
Yeah.
2.5. Oh, I think it might be 2-3.
Oh.
I'm hearing 2-3. Yeah. What are we saying, 2-3?
I say 2-3, yeah.
They're going for it, they're behind it.
Speech.
Well, we know we've got half points, sure.
Yeah, well, they added up to a half point.
Right then, let's move on. What are you trying to do when you get more than one?
Okay. So, thank you very much for joining us for the Word on the Street round. We should be back after a short break with our next round, which will be called Overly Pretentious. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. We shall see you soon after a quick ad break. Okay. Bye. We are back with round number two. This will be called Overly Pretentious. Overly Pretentious is a game in which each one of you four shall come up with a rephrasing of a sentence I give you. And whoever gets the most pretentious rephrasing of these sentences will win a point.
May I just ask one question?
Huh? You, of course you may.
What does pretentious mean?
Pretentious means, you know, when someone wants to try and sound smart, but they don't quite do it. They use lots of big words to try and sound smart. It's unacceptable, isn't it? Just unacceptable.
I don't even say my full name.
I haven't even said anything about point attributing, so there's no bonus points scored for that one, unfortunately.
Wow.
Okay. It was quite funny, but
come on, man.
No points attributed for funny ads in this one, because otherwise the round would just go horribly wrong. So, our first sentence, you're going to have a minute or so to think about it, is the quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. I will repeat that. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. I would like each one of you to come up with a short but pretentious definition, not definition, rephrasing of that sentence. This bit's happening, yeah, what does that mean?
Okay, is there like any, can you repeat words?
You can repeat words, yeah. Right.
There's no time limit.
We just need a short sentence saying exactly the same thing as I just said, only in different phrasing, if that makes sense. Mm. So your word again, sentence again. The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. Who wants to go first?
I'm going to nominate James.
I don't want to.
All right, well, you've been nominated by a team member, which is how it works, unfortunately, now. So James, the quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog. Take it away, my friend. Any time soon, please?
No.
No?
Somebody pass first.
Dara, your definition next. Your sentence.
I'm going to go with the slow brown fox jumped over the active dog.
Just the opposite of what I said, I like it. And you?
I got a point for that comment.
The fox at a velocity of Mach 2.
Well, this is how we do it.
Leaped. Nice. Oh wait, was it leaped or jumped?
It was jumped originally.
Leaped over the lazy. No, this lazy bitch.
I like that. Bonus point already, I've got that thing of it. Might be our winner, so unless Jago is
point. Yeah, no bonus points.
At my discretion.
I'm also a part of his team.
Okay, so bonus. Alright, I'm giving our win on this one to
Jago. Oh,
I know, he passed because.
Well, no, yeah, I figured that he's going to beat yours anyway, so there's no need
Righto! So, ladies and gentlemen, your next sentence to remake in the most pretentious way you can. Start with Jago this time, because we start with the opposite end of the line. Your sentence is, your tea is ready. I'll say it again, your tea is ready. Take it away, Jago.
Your evening meal has reached maximum capacity. As win for your enjoyment.
I like that. That's a good one, ladies and gentlemen. Right. Okay, Daniel, have you got something that can top that?
Your brewing leaves from India.
Oh, I like that.
It is scaldingly. Oh, no, I can't.
You can't top Jamie on that one. Alright, Dowie, it's your turn. Can we have a rephrasing of your tea is ready?
Is. Like tea meaning dinner or like cup of tea?
It's down to interpretation.
Well, your tea reached boiling point.
Okay, James, it looks like the responsibility to swing this round back in your favour rests on your shoulders.
Oh, shut up.
So, can we have a rephrasing of your tea is ready?
If you just give me one minute.
We're running out of moments to give you, unfortunately.
That's not fair.
Yeah, it is. About all the time when they went away.
Wait, can I think
of? Your tea is ready.
I like that one.
He's passed. Alright, I'm gonna have to give the win to Jago's here.
Wow.
Bonus point for Jago.
It's a bit biased.
You two have got some catching up to do, that's all I'm gonna say. So, your next sentence, to rephrase in the most pretentious way possible, is, hi, how are you? Starting with Dowie this time.
Hi. Hmm? You look sad. Can I cheer you up?
Well, I mean, it's certainly one way of doing it. It's an interesting interpretation.
It's
James, on to yours very quickly.
Hello, good sir.
Ah.
Hello.
Good start.
Don't stop.
How are you?
You literally just took the same sentence and added good sir. With absolutely no change to the sentence. Right.
It made you laugh.
It did, I did. Bonus point at least.
Yes.
Bonus
Get
point
it.
At least. For that shit show. Yeah, blur that, I'm sorry. Right, okay, so our next... Let me cut that. Alright, well, your definition very quickly, we've got 5 more seconds, let's go. Speed round.
Greetings, fellow gentlemen. How art thee? Bow. How art thou?
How art thou?
He messed that up.
I'm going to have to give the point to good sir.
Yeah,
such a good one as well.
Alright, okay, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm going to give him a chance.
No, after a quick
no,
we're
going
to move on to our next round.
Brilliant.
We're going to move on to our next round after a quick break. Thank you very much. Keep it going. Break. No break, carry on.
No, can Jago say his?
Alright, I'm getting mixed messages, but that's fine. So, we're going to move on very quickly to our third and final round of the show, Hood Songbirds. In this one, you both teams are going to give me a consensus on whether the short sentence that I read out is a tweet, is a tweet or a song lyric. Okay. So, our first one, not smiling makes me smile.
That's
decide amongst yourselves, or is it a song lyric or a tweet?
That's a tweet.
We're going with song.
Okay, so you're voting on song lyric, apparently.
This is a tweet, I'm beating
you
up.
Tweet.
Okay, so we've got tweet and song lyric. The answer is in fact a tweet. Kanye West. Kanye West tweets that. I believe we're on 2013. Okay. So. Our next tweet or song lyric is, those who have fought me and lost so badly, they just don't know what to do. Is it a tweet or a song lyric? Confer amongst yourselves, come back
with a song.
They're going with song. What are you guys going with? Are you going to agree or disagree with them?
What do you think would be a pretty cringy tweet?
Yeah, but then again, I feel like it didn't give much grief before I go with a song.
Okay, we'll go tweet then.
You're going tweet and song. Song and tweet, yeah?
Yeah, it's probably something Jay-Z's tweets.
It's a tweet by Donald Trump.
I told you.
It's a Donald Trump tweet, ladies and gentlemen, referring to his presidential election. So, our next one. Past me, past behind me even, like a ponytail. Is that a tweet or a song lyric?
Song.
They're going song lyric, or are you totally just going?
Yeah, we'll go song as well.
Going song lyric. Is it about a lyric by Drake?
Oh yeah, boy. Drake. I knew that.
He could get out.
Okay. What about this? I'm on my 14 carats. Is that a tweet or a song lyric?
That's like a tweet on a photo.
Song lyric.
I say song. Like,
sounds like a song.
So
like
you consensing on song lyric?
Yeah.
We're going song. Let's go for song.
Probably from Rice Guns.
It is indeed a lyric. It's Selena Gomez, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh god.
Selena Gomez with that banger.
Don't respect it.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, this is a tricky one. This is our last one. This is either a tweet or a song lyric again. I hope it doesn't take for me to die, for you to see what I do for you. Is that going to be a tweet, or is that going to be a song lyric?
We're going to
have a tweet. Song lyric.
Song lyric or tweet then? Tweet. I want an agreement.
Tweet.
I'm hearing tweet. Are you agreeing on tweet? No. He said it loud.
Get out. It's a tweet. We're going to tweet.
Okay. So we got tweet there, and song lyric there. Yeah?
I'll
say song.
Going song and tweet, yeah? Okay, well, it's in fact a tweet.
Yes!
For a,
what do you
just
know?
To trust get
for a bonus down. Point, ladies and gentlemen. Bonus point. Can you tell me who tweeted that? Let me read it to you again.
Justin Bieber.
I hope it doesn't take for me to die for you to see what I do for you.
That's
who
definitely
tweeted that?
Justin Bieber.
Oh, I said that
it's
last
not Justin Bieber. Let me see if Daniel. Ladies and gentlemen, Daniel tweeted that around.
Is it Drake?
It's not Drake.
No. Luke.
It was not Luca. Well, it sounds like the kind of thing he'd say. It's not Jago either.
What is your obsession with me?
I hope it doesn't take for me to die for you to see what I do.
David Cameron.
No, indeed, ladies and gentlemen, it is Jaden Smith.
Oh, I was trying to.
Yeah.
All right, that's all we have for you in the third round. we're going to have the final scores in just a minute. Alright, we're going to have your scores up in just a second.
Are you not keeping count yourself?
I'm not keeping count myself, no. Okay, we've got 6 points to Team JG and 4 points.
Oh, get it.
What is that even work out? You mean 6 points to 4 points?
Calm down, ladies.
6 points to four.
Thank you very much for joining us
three
today.
3 rounds in a row.
Thank you very much, everybody, and I hope you'll join me next time on the Funny Game Show Quiz.
So good,
thank you.
Are you going to talk about the fact that we just won?
Yeah.